Hello and welcome to my video tutorial. I created this video to demonstrate how to resolve a certain issue in Windows 7. The issue prevents regular users from logging in. Administrators can still log in, but an informational message pops up every time saying that Windows cannot connect to the group policy client services. My computer had this problem for several months. My internet search for a fix did not bring any viable solution. Most of the recommendations were to reinstall the operating system, which means doing everything from scratch. I dedicated about 2 full days to troubleshoot the issue myself, and finally came up with a solution which I'd like to share with you. The solution is effective and quite simple, and it does not require restoring from a backup or reinstalling Windows, which is the best part. This is my computer's desktop and I just logged in as administrator. As I mentioned before, only administrators can log in to the system, and once you log in, the Windows shows a message saying it cannot connect to the group policy client service. The message also suggests to check the system event log for details, and if you go there, you will find that Windows updates were installing and the computer restart was attempted. However, the restart did not complete because the computer had crashed. You will also find an informational message saying that the last computer shutdown was not clean. As a result of the crash, some registry values got corrupted, which makes group policy client service failing to start. To fix the problem, we have to restore missing registry settings. We will use Registry Editor to do that. To open Registry Editor, press the Windows key and letter R at the same time. This will bring Run window, where you will type RegEdit and click OK button. RegEdit is a system program and Windows will ask you for elevated permissions. Accept it by clicking Yes. The Registry Editor window will then open. Use the left side of the registry editor to navigate through the registry tree. First, go to HK Local Machine, System, Current Control Set, Services, and look for GPSVC key folder. This key is responsible for group policy client services. We want to make sure it is not corrupt. GPSVC folder has multiple parameters. One of the parameters called image path, and it defines how group policy client services are started. Here it is. If you look at the details, you will see that it calls SVC host program with parameter called GPSVC group. GPSVC group parameter is the one that's causing the problem. It's supposed to be in another registry path, but as we will see, it is missing. That makes group policy client services failing to start. Now let's move along and take a look at that registry path. This time we'll go to HK Local Machine, Software, Microsoft, Windows NT, Current Version, and SVC host. SVC host is a core Windows program that runs many different services. This registry folder contains instructions for SVC host program about how to run each individual service. All services are listed on the right side with corresponding subfolders on the left. As you can see, there is no GPSVC group string for the group policy client service on the right, and there is no corresponding subfolder on the left. That's the reason this service is failing. Let's fix it. We'll start from the right side. Right-click on the blank space, choose New, and click Multi-String Value. A new variable will be created, which we will call GPSVC group. When done, double-click on this new variable and set its value to GPSVC in this Edit Multi-String window. When done, click OK. Now we need to create a subfolder on the left side. To do that, right-click on the SVC host folder, select New, and then Key. A new subfolder will be created, and we'll name it the same way, GPSVC group. We are almost done. This folder is empty and we need to create 2 variables here. Both variables will be of the type dword. Let's create the first one. Right-click on the blank space again and choose DWORD. Name this new variable Authentication Capabilities, one word, no spaces. When done, double-click on the new variable and set its value to 3020 in hexadecimal format. And finally, the last variable. Right-click on the blank space and create DWORD variable. This variable must be named CoInitializeSecurityParam. It's one word. And again, when finished, double-click and set this variable to have a value of 1. Alright, now we are done with the changes. We can close the registry editor now and restart the computer to make sure the problem is fixed. Let's wait until computer boots up. And once it's on, I will log on as administrator again. Well, as you see, the desktop came up, and so far we have no messages, which is a good sign. To be completely sure that the issue is gone, let's go to the computer management and check if Group Policy Client Service is running. To do that, click on the Start button, then right-click on the computer and select Manage. When computer management screen opens, expand Services and Application on the left side and click on the Services just below. This will open the list of all services running on the computer in the middle of the screen, right here. So let's scroll down until we get to the Group Policy Client Services and check that the status is started. As you see, it is. That means that the issue is fixed and we will have no more problems. This ends my tutorial. I hope you will find it helpful in resolution of your problem. For a technical description of the issue and the resolution, please follow the link in the description for this video. I'll also be glad to hear from you, so don't be shy to leave me the comments below. And thank you for watching.